While video game developer BioWare had worked on projects as diverse as the first-person shooter Shattered Steel and third-person actioner MDK2, they were most famous for their RPG masterpieces like Baldur's Gate and Knights of the Old Republic. But recognizing that point-and-click adventures were fast becoming obsolete, the company began making more action-oriented games with Jade Empire. Looking forward, however, BioWare recognized that high-definition shooters, casual handheld games, and massively multiplayer experiences were all rising to prominence. And so, a studio with no experience with any of these genres decided it was time to do all of them. There had been rumors of a shooter RPG hybrid coming out of BioWare since 2004. But it wasn't until October 2005 that they officially announced Mass Effect, a science fiction epic designed to be a trilogy. While they had developed the oddball MDK2, this would be the first hardcore shooter the studio had worked on. Shooters were, and are, notorious for having weak storylines. BioWare wanted to take the quality, in-depth narratives they were famous for and map it onto the proven Unreal 3 engine to make a game that would attract fans from across genre lines. As with other BioWare games, it was delayed a few times, but in November 2007, Mass Effect finally released to the Xbox 360.
You can't possibly understand what's really at stake.
Lucky for you, I'm anything but average.
The title completely retooled the way that RPGs handled dialogue. Instead of merely having a text bubble or a static view of other characters' faces, Mass Effect introduced cinematic, multi-angle conversations. Additionally, it broke the tradition of one-sided discussions by fully voicing the main character, no matter if the player chose to be male or female.
This is Commander Shepard speaking.
We have our orders. Find Saren before he finds the conduit. I won't lie to you, crew. This mission isn't going to be easy.
On top of this, BioWare recalibrated their morality gauge so that it wasn't simply good and evil. Instead, all decisions were varying shades of gray and represented differing philosophies, forcing the player to make choices more intellectually and emotionally challenging than most other games on the market.
You have a problem with me, Chief?
You questioned my competence through the entire mission.
Best way to stop that is to show me you're competent.
All of this wrapped around an incredibly rich, detailed world with fleshed-out characters and yet another epic quest. Sadly, the outstanding presentation suffered from frequent texture pop-ins that broke the otherwise immersive experience. Other artifacts of BioWare's rush to the already delayed finish line include simplistic side quests with repetitive designs and a shooting system that didn't measure up to the game's phenomenal story. Also, there were elevators. An attempt to spice up loading times by having the characters interact during the ride. They ended up as the game's signature flaw. But in the end, these were minor annoyances in a stellar experience. Mass Effect received fawning praise from critics and gamers, and was one of holiday 2007's biggest hits. However, in January 2008, the game was singled out by media watchdogs for its depictions of sexuality. A blog post by Kevin McCullough, and later a news segment on Fox News, lambasted the Sexbox title for allowing child gamers to sodomize anything they wanted with full control over all actions and for showing uncensored nudity. Unfortunately for them, none of that was actually true. The M-rated game contains two non-interactive sex scenes that are mostly left to the imagination. In the end, the uproar really demonstrated that many people still assume that video games are made only for kids and that sex in media is an even hotter issue than violence. None of that stopped the game from selling, especially once it was later released on PC. But even with another hit on their hands, BioWare knew that if they wanted to banish pop-ins forever, they needed more resources. And so, in 2008, the joint Pandemic BioWare venture was bought outright by Electronic Arts. That September saw the company's first release under EA's ownership, though the game was published by Sega, Sonic Chronicles: The Dark Brotherhood for the Nintendo DS. It was the iconic character's first RPG, in which he had to solve a big mystery, recruiting allies in his epic quest, and save the world from impending doom. Sound familiar? And indeed, the title was faulted for having a cliché storyline in addition to poorly thought-out gameplay mechanics. Uncharacteristically for BioWare, the game received lukewarm to mediocre reviews. However, it was universally praised for staying absolutely true to Sonic and his universe, and is considered one of the Hedgehog's better games in recent years. By early 2009, with EA's money behind it, BioWare had so many projects going forward at once that they had opened a new studio in Montreal just to handle the overflow. In June of that year, EA leveraged its ownership rights and merged BioWare with Mythic Entertainment, another RPG developer. This effectively meant that EA put BioWare in charge of Mythic, since BioWare's executives took control of the joint venture and Mythic's head was shown the door. As such, the Canadian developer is now the head of EA's entire RPG division. That same month, BioWare released its second handheld game, Mass Effect Galaxy, for the iPhone OS. It was a two-hour top-down shooter, and combined with the novels Mass Effect had spawned, demonstrated BioWare's desire to turn the property into a full multimedia IP. But the company's big release of 09 was Dragon Age Origins after 5 years in development.
Great Andraste, I pray you, stay your wrath!
Returning to medieval fantasy for the first time since Neverwinter Nights, the game allowed players to choose from one of six possible origin stories before setting off into the main quest, where you must recruit allies to fight the invasion of the evil... oh, you know! More than any other BioWare game to date, Dragon Age went straight for the mature crowd, with persistent blood splatter painting your characters and brutal behavior from the good guys. Unfazed by the Mass Effect controversy, Dragon Age still had romantic subplots that can lead to sexual encounters, including same-sex encounters. The entire game can last for dozens of hours, especially if a gamer wants to play through all six origin stories. The game has sold well on PC, Xbox 360, and PlayStation 3, though it didn't make the same impact on the gaming world as its spiritual predecessor, Baldur's Gate. Going forward, BioWare will release the cleverly titled Mass Effect 2 in late January 2010. It will be the first game to read the save file of its predecessor to determine how it plays. In other words, the choices you made in the first game will directly impact the second. Promising improved classes, better combat, slicker graphics, and faster elevators, it hopes to carry on Mass Effect's good name and expand on it. And at the same time, BioWare is hard at work expanding off another good name, with Star Wars: The Old Republic. It will be the developer's first step into the MMO world, and will test whether the single-player juggernaut can play in the multiplayer realm. It promises to be the first fully voiced MMO in history, across multiple languages.
Enemy is firing. Turbo lasers, missiles, and what looks like transport pods. I'm not sure.
The pods are a distraction. Return fire. Aim for their power generators.
With the huge name of Star Wars to live up to, the company realized that the project would quickly become so massive that it would require its own studio. And so, they created BioWare Austin in Texas to work exclusively on the title. And in the meantime, BioWare has teased that they have other games in development, but haven't revealed what they are yet. More sequels to beloved titles, or new worlds with new characters. They have stated that Mass Effect 3 is already underway. Even though they are experimenting with shooters and MMOs, one thing BioWare has never strayed from is their belief that any genre deserves a stellar narrative. Where most studios concentrate on gameplay first and only throw a story together later, the developer has proven that careful attention to detail, complex moral choices, and emotionally engaging characters make for massive hits. Combined with a loving attention to art design and evolving gameplay mechanics, BioWare has crafted a reputation for consistent excellence across tones, properties, and 15 years of a changing industry that a couple of doctors from Canada thought they'd try out.
I need more than words.
I'd be disappointed if I could persuade you that easily. Go and see for yourself.
There is only one measure of success. Kill or be killed.
The bomb has been planted!